In this video, I'm going to talk about coins in Project Spark. Recently, I've received a couple of questions about how coins work, how could we use coins to create a store in our games, or how could we maybe use coins to upgrade a tower and tower defense. Some different ideas like that have been coming in, so I wanted to talk about coins. So I've added 3 coins from the prop gallery. They have the default brains on them. So let me just test and show how a coin behaves. So the default coin, when it's on the ground, it sort of spins around waiting to be picked up. When you touch it, you get a visual effect. And then after you've picked up your first coin, you get this icon in the upper right that shows a picture of a coin and then how many coins that you've got. That number is a coin counter. And that's not in the, that icon is not in the player's brain by default. There's no display coin counter or anything in this default brain. So that is this line here, line 4. There's a display coin count brain in the gallery. You can look at that. It's just one line that says display the icon and the display the number. And so by adding the brain, so this is part of the multi-brain system, it doesn't matter what type of character you have, this it will get a coin count displayed. So by putting this in the coin takes care of all that for you. I'm not going to go through the entire brain, but these are the two crucial lines, 5 and 6. When you pick up a coin, increment the coin counter variable in the player. And then the player pick up me, that means put the coin object itself into the player's inventory. So there's two components to a coin. There's the coin count, or coin counter, and that's the value of the coin. And then the coin itself is an object that is put into your inventory. So I've got a really simple way to display your inventory. For each of inventory, display it, and then I'm displaying at the screen top left. So the way that works is when I pick up a coin in the top left, it'll display the items that are in my inventory. So I have 3 coins in my inventory. I've added a right bumper to drop. So I drop a coin, so it's no longer in my inventory. And then that coin brain automatically deducts itself from the coin counter when you drop it. So if I drop all 3 of these, I should have, so the coin counter is 0 now. So now I've coded this goblin. He's going to act as my store. When I interact with him, he'll take one of my coins and he'll give me a sword. So my coin counter has gone down. If you look on the left, the actual inventory, there's no coin, there's only 2 coins in my inventory, and now I have 1 sword. If I interact 2 more times, I have 3 swords and no coins. So his brain is pretty simple. This sword here is the template that he's using. It's just a regular sword. So his brain says when interacted, set this player variable equal to me. That's the it is what is interacting with him. When the player's coin counter is greater than or equal to 1, so as long as I've got some coins, decrement by 1, so take away 1 of the coin number. So this is, remember, this is the counter that keeps track of the number. And then create a sword. Let's scroll down a little bit, that box is getting in the way. And then give that item, in this case the sword, to the player. And then if the player has a coin in its inventory, then give that coin to me. And by using it, even though this returns the list of inventory items that are coins, even though I have more than 1, I'm using it, which is a singular noun, I guess. If I'd use them, then it would give all the coins. So if I do this, I have 3 coins, and now I interact with him. Now he's taken all of my coins. Notice I didn't do the coin counter correctly. I only charged myself 1 coin. So it says I have 2, but there's actually none in my inventory, so that would be a bug, I guess. And so he will still sell me 3 coins, even though he took them all. Alright, so by doing it, it just takes the first coin that it finds and gives it to the goblin. So those are coins. That's a very simple way to do coins. Now, if you're playing a game like Super Mario Brothers, for example, Mario doesn't carry around his coins. He just picks them up and gets them as a score point. So instead of player pick up me, what I would do here is I would say destroy me, and we'll make this, we'll just recolor it a little bit. Oops. So if you get one of the green coins, so the green coin is the style of coin you have in like Super Mario Brothers. You get a coin counter increase, so if you see the number up there, but you don't actually get an item in your inventory like you do this. Depending on what type of game you have, you may not want to deal with the coin objects themselves. So in that case, like in your store, you would just deduct one from the coin counter and not even worry about the objects. Don't even add them to your inventory. If your game is going to have, you know, hundreds of coins, then you don't want to carry around pockets full of identical items in your inventory. So that's another way to use coins. It's a little different from the default brain.